Hi, myself Atul SG. Today we are going to discuss about different types of communication protocols in PLC.
Different types of communication protocols in PLC automation. Introduction. What is communication protocol? A communication protocol is a system of rules that allows two or more entities of a communication system to transmit information via any kind of variation of physical quantities, or we can explain it as a communication protocol is a system of rules for data exchange within or between computers, PLCs, control device, etc. A protocol can be implemented as hardware, software, or in both terms. And then communication systems typically do not use a single protocol to handle a transmission. It sometimes use multiple protocols to complete a transmission. Instead of they use a set of cooperating protocols, sometimes it can be called as a protocol family or protocol suite. So here we are going to study about some major types of communication protocols used in industrial automation. So first one is called RS-232 or RS-485 communication. This commonly known as serial port communication. And next one is Ethernet IP and other HART protocol. Then we have the Modbus RTU, remote terminal units. And the next is PROFINET communication protocol. Then we have the PROFIBUS. And finally, interbus communication protocols. We are gonna learn the basics of all this type of communication protocols. This is a figure for different types of protocol used in our industrial field. See, you can see that computers are connected through the Ethernet communication cables. Then you can see the PROFIBUS communication, HART communication, RS-484, etc. This is a picture representation. You can see that these different PLCs are connected with these communication cables. Each one communicate with other devices. Each device is communicate with other with some set of rules, or we can call it as protocols. So next is RS-232. RS-232 is a serial communication protocol. RS-232 is an asynchronous communication method. We can use a binary system to transmit our data in ASCII format. PLC series ports is used for transmission reception of data. It works by sending and receiving a voltage. With RS-232, normally a single bit is represented by a voltage of -12 and a zero by represent +12 volt. The voltage between +3 volts is considered as there are two types of RS-232 devices.
So this is an example for serial communication port. This one is Siemens S7-200 PLC. So here we can see that this communication port is serial port. And next we have another company called Allen Bradley. It's Micrologic 1000 PLC. So here we can see that DFN device serial communication port. So different companies have different types of communication ports. And here you can see that this is a Allen Bradley's communication cable. Take this cable and we can connect this cable like this. Then the other end goes to the PC or laptop. We have another module called serial to USB converter. So most of the time we use this USB serial adapter to convert the serial port to USB type. Let's see how we can connect this USB adapter or converter by using this serial communication cable. First, we need to connect the port to PLC. Like this, then we'll take the another end, then we need to connect this to this adapter port, like this. Then this port will goes to the our PC or laptop. Another widely used industrial communication standard is Profinet. That's basically we know that it's RJ45 cable. So this type of cables are used as in Profinet communication.
Next we have RS-485 communication. Unlike RS-232, in RS-485 is a multi-drop and two-wire communication that allows us to communicate to multiple devices at the same time. That means we are getting a full duplex communication in this RS-485 system. According to the standard, up to 32 devices can be connected at the same time. Maximum distance from the end to end, that means main device to end device, that can be end up to 1,200 meters. Many PLC allow connecting up to 128 slave nodes by using repeaters. However, both the total number of devices and maximum distance can be extended. We can use repeaters in between the slave nodes. In RS-485 network, we can be used as a two-wire or four-wire network. In four-wire network, the direction is bidirectional. That means we can communicate vice versa at the same time. Simultaneously, two-way communication is possible. For example, our telephone communication. At the same time, the sender and receiver can talk to each other. Whereas in two-wire communication, the networks only allows in communication in one direction. Okay. And next we have the Ethernet IP and Ethernet TCP per IP protocol. This is the widely used communication protocol in networking industry as well as the industrial automation field. IP, which expands internet network or internet protocol, generally called as, is a protocol to send data between computers, possibly using Ethernet links and other types of links like Wi-Fi. We are all familiar with Wi-Fi and Ethernet. IP is mainly responsible for the routing, that is finding the optimum path between the source and the destination of each packet transmitted. And next we have the TCP protocol. When it expands, it's called as transfer control protocol. It's one of the most commonly used protocol and protocol that run via IP. Its responsibility is to make sense of the data, for example, via ports for different kinds of data, and also to make sure packets of the data are treated in a right order, and so on. TCP, when expands transfer control protocol, is one of the protocol that runs via IP. Its responsibility is to make the sense of data, for example, via ports for different kinds of data, and also to make sure packets of the data are treated in the right order, and so on. Then we have the OSI model for this TCP/IP protocol. We have 7 layers in OSI model. We have 7 layers in OSI model. First one is the physical layer. Next one is the data link layer, network layer, transport layer, session layer, presentation layer, application layer. In physical layer, the information is called as bits, can be transmitted through media, signal, and binary transformation. Commonly includes the electrical signals and cabling. Then we have the MAC data link layer. MAC means the media access control address. In here, the transmitted packets from the node to node based on station address. Or here the bits can be arranged in the form of frames. Next we have the network layer. In network layer, the routers data to different LAN or WAN, local area networks to wide area networks based on networking addresses. Here we can convert the frames into packets. In the network layer, we are basically determine the path or logical addressing or setting the IP, and these all done in network layer. Then the packets are converted into segments that will be in the transport layer. In transport layer, it is ensures the delivery of the entire files or message. Here it will check the end-to-end connection and reliability. And next we have the session layer. In session layer, start stop sessions is added. Maintains the message order. Here also done the part that inter-host communication part is done here. And next we have the presentation layer. Here our data is encrypted. Data conversion is in the presentation layer, ASCII to BCD to binary, etc. Data conversion is done in presentation layer. Then finally, we have the application layer. Types here we can use the messaging or normal format by using the email or softwares like file transfer. Next, we have the HART communication protocol. The next one's HART is Highway Addressable Remote Transducer Protocol. In HART technology, there will be a master and slave type protocol. The HART protocol can be used in various modes such as point to point or multi drop for communicating information to and from smart field instruments and central control or monitoring systems. The HART protocol provides for up to two masters, mainly primary and secondary masters. This allows secondary masters such as handheld communicators to be used without interfering with the communication to from the primary master, that is control bar monitoring system. Here we can see the HART communication. This is a HART enabled IO. This is a field instrument. The transmission is in digital data or analog 4 to 20 milliampere volt current. Then we have the Modbus communication. Modbus RTU, Modbus Relay Remote Terminal Units. In Modbus RTU is an open serial, another serial protocol communication. Modbus RTU is an open serial communication protocol derived from the master-slave architecture, originally developed by Modicon. Now it's called as Schneider Electronics. It is widely accepted serial level protocol due to its ease of use and reliability. Modbus RTU is widely used within the industrial automation system and home automation system, building management system, robotics, etc. Modbus RTU messages are simple 16-bit structure with a cyclic redundancy checksum. That means an error detection method, CRC. The simplicity of this message is to ensure the reliability of the message. This is the Modbus architecture. There are two types of Modbus communication architecture, unicast and multicast. Mainly in unicast, there is only one master and a slave. Master will produce a request to the slave, then the slave device will reply to the master. In multicast transmission, the master and a different number of slaves are there. Master produce a common request with a set of address, slave address. Then all the slaves are replies to master. Here you can see the Modbus RPU communication. Main Modbus master is here. Then the master is generating a read-write request to the slaves. And corresponding to this read-write request, master also generates the slave's address. And it will go to the slave represented slave, then the slave is respond to the master. That means return the reply. Next we have the Profibus and Profinet. These are widely used industrial communication standard protocol. Profibus is a classical serial field bus, and Profinet is a industrial Ethernet. Profinet is faster with more bandwidth and larger messages. But in Profibus protocol, it is designed for high speed communication with distributed IO devices, or we can call it as remote IOs, input output. There are many Profibus devices are available from a variety of manufacturers. These devices range from simple input or output modules to motor controls and PLCs. A Profibus DP, or when expands, decentralized periphery. It is a device is a Profibus DP, or when expands, a Profibus decentralized periphery device is any peripheral device which processes information and sent its output to master. The DP device forms a passive station on the network and can only acknowledge the received messages or send response to the message to the master upon the request. A Profibus DP device have the same priority, and all the network communication originates from the master. Whereas in Profinet, the Profinet is a newer Ethernet-based industrial communication standard. As we discussed in the Ethernet IP, TCP per IP protocol, the same protocols are used in Profinet. The physical interface used for Profinet is standard RJ45. Ethernet jack. Profinet cables are easily recognizable by their green color or ash color. While in some cases, standard Ethernet cable may be used to connect two Profinet devices. Official Profinet cable should be used as they contain robust shielding and designed to function, withstand the higher harsh conditions and temperature environment. That means higher temperature, pressure, cold condition. Profinet devices have three different types of addresses. Mainly they are IP addressing, MAC addressing, and device name. All Ethernet devices use IP addresses and MAC addresses, but the device name is unique to Profinet devices. Due to its higher speed and greater flexibility, Profinet is becoming the preferred communication protocol for the industrial application. That means Profinet is commonly used in most of the communication systems. And finally, we have the Interbus. In Interbus is a serial bus system which transmits data between control systems such as PC, PLC, robot controllers, etc. It is one of the leading field bus system in the automation industry, and is fully standardized according to the European standard EN50254 and IEC standard 61158. They are specially distributed IO modules that are connected to sensors and actuators, such as temperature sensors, position switches, actuators, etc. In terms of topology, Interbus is a ring system, or we can, all devices are connected, actively integrated in closed communication path. This is a figure for the Interbus communication system. The PC-PLC communication is here, and by the cabling, we have the Interbus devices. Number of Interbus devices up to N. Then each one have a process data.